Welcome back to the channel, everyone. Here's a topic that I've been thinking of doing for quite some time, but recently, when Safcom reached out to me via text and offered to give me an upgrade on my home internet for 500 shillings to get the silver package, which is basically 20 Mbps, I thought that maybe this is the right time to do this. Which is the best home internet you could get yourself in Kenya 2021? Let's get started. So as I've already mentioned, I've been using the Safaricom home fiber, and it's basically fiber to the home. That's literally fiber transmission of internet all the way from wherever it comes from to your router / access point in your house. And that's a good thing. Modern technology improves your reliability, but we'll talk about that in a bit. So I've been using it for the past about 4 years, and today I thought, what other options do we have? Would I recommend that you get Safcom home fiber, or is there anything else that you could look at? Okay, to make things simple and as far as value is concerned, we'll be doing some mathematical calculations to find out how much do various services around offer per Mbps. And Mbps is not megabytes per second, as many people would imagine, but it's megabits per second. It's a measure of speed, not the quantity of data. And so assuming your allocation of bandwidth is a certain amount of water in a tank, the more taps you open, the less the pressure comes out of each tap. So I guess you get the point that higher Mbps will result in faster speeds and can support more devices. Say you have a phone, a computer, your TV. Nowadays everyone runs smart TVs, you know. So I guess when you talk about megabits per second, you understand what exactly is happening here. And so I've been looking around, and it seems like there are basically three major providers of home fiber in Kenya. There's more internet service providers, the likes of Airtel, Telkom, who offer some kind of broadband internet, or rather internet that is basically wireless from some access point that they install somewhere. But there's just three providers that I know of that actually offer some sort of fiber connection direct to your home. And that's Safaricom Home, then there's Fiber by Jamii Telecommunications, JTL, and there's Liquid Telecom. I've tried to look at what packages they offer to find out which is the best value. Because recently, and I took up that upgrade, Safaricom was asking for 3,500 shillings per month for 20 Mbps. And if you do some quick calculation, that comes to about 175 shillings per Mbps. And that's actually quite high compared to other countries in the developed world, even some places in Africa, but it is what it is. So I was trying to look at whether or not to upgrade, and I found out that the base package that I was subscribed to, you know, was actually 3000 bob for 8 Mbps, and that comes to 305 shillings per Mbps, and that's quite high. Considering this new package, though, I don't know how long it will last. It's actually just 175 bob per Mbps. Now, previously, this silver package was 4100 shillings for 20 Mbps, and that's 205 shillings per Mbps. Then the next package up was 158 bob per Mbps. Then the largest package for 100 Mbps was 125 bob per Mbps. So you can see how they scale. Safaricom basically offers cheaper internet if you're going to go for the higher tiers, the more expensive packages. And that's some basic economics of how markets behave. Even when you visit your nearest supermarket, you'll find that 1 kg of flour does not cost two times the cost of 500 grams. It's kind of a bit cheaper. So usually the higher you go, the cheaper it becomes, but the more expensive it becomes. So it comes down to nothing if the experience is horrible. About the reliability, I think Safaricom has been good. Like, you might actually experience some downtime probably like once in a month, which is acceptable, I guess. And the speed is actually usually as promised. If I run a speed test right now, look at this. Okay, we are getting 17 Mbps download and about 21-22 Mbps up. So yeah, 17 is probably a bit slow, but I suspect something else is happening in the house right now, because just a few hours ago, I actually got 21 up and 21 down. So it's not nice numbers to talk about in front of people from other countries who do 1 gigabit per second up and down, but that's what we have. And yeah, it's good enough for what I do, the occasional uploads to YouTube, Streaming, I don't watch any free-to-air TV or the likes of DSTV and so on. I stream everything 100%. And yeah, the wife is also on the net all the time. So yeah, for two people, even this bronze package at 8 Mbps is, I can say, good enough. Right now we're doing this silver, which is awesome. I don't think I would need this gold or the diamond packages, so that is it. But the downsides of Safaricom Home Fiber, I think number one is what you can't avoid. It's a shared connection, and Safaricom have really done some good marketing. They've pushed it, so I'm hoping that at some point there won't be much more customers than they can actually support, and so the quality of service goes down. The other thing is there is no more free installation. When I got connected initially, I actually paid nothing. The router was given to me for free. In fact, I moved houses and I was given a second router for free. That cannot happen right now. In fact, I can just read here on their terms and conditions right now that a new connection is 3,000 bob, though there is some sort of reward that you are given after 3 months, then another one after 6 months for 1,500 bob. Then the second one is also 1,500 bob, so I guess it's still kind of free, but pegged on the fact that you need to keep paying for your subscription every month for 6 months so you can get back your connection fee. But then something else they're talking about up here is there's actually a 6,500 shillings replacement fee for the router, like if you move houses and you don't carry your previous router. So that's what's happening right now. So guys, I'm just editing this video over here and I've found out some two important pieces of information that I believe this would not be complete if we did not cover. And the first is actually coverage. I believe all this is gibberish if you can't access these things, but Safaricom Home Fiber seems to have the greatest coverage of all the networks we're talking about. They're available in Mombasa, Nairobi, Nanyuki, Nyeri, Bungoma, Kakamega, and so yeah, they're the most available network. For fiber, I don't seem to find a reliable coverage map. And the same goes for Liquid. I also don't seem to find a reliable map. But I believe that for both fiber and Liquid, you expect to find them in the major towns, probably Nairobi, Mombasa, Kisumu. These other smaller towns might be served by their WiMAX, or rather the broadband wireless connection, but probably not the fiber to the home connection. And something else that is important that I think I was about to overlook is the fact that I have actually found that there is yet another provider of fiber called Zuku. Actually, we all know about Zuku, only that I wasn't sure that they actually do fiber to the home. I thought it's probably just broadband connection, but from their website, it seems like they actually do fiber to the home. And I can see that they have packages all the way from 10 to 60 Mbps. And some of their packages are also the triple play packages tied with their TV network. But in this video, I'm only talking about internet access. And so for their internet only packages, I see that they start at 2,800 Kenyan shillings for 10 Mbps. That is about 280 shillings per Mbps. And they go all the way up to 6,000 bob for 60 Mbps, and that's 100 bob per Mbps, which seems like it's actually quite good for the higher tier if you're going to go for the 100 Mbps. But then in as far as reliability is concerned, I'm sure a lot of us have heard at one point or another a story about Zuku. So maybe you guys can comment down below and tell me if you'd take Zuku over like Safaricom Home Fiber or JTL Fiber. Would you? But for the 10 and the 20 Mbps packages, they actually don't beat Safaricom and JTL Fiber in terms of value. And in as far as the availability is concerned, it seems like they're only available in Nairobi, Nakuru, Kisumu, and Mombasa. So yeah, there you have it. Let's get back to the video. Now the next provider among the biggest players in the market is this JTL, the fiber. You guys probably know this fiber guy, and their base package, as you can see, is 5,250 shillings for 30 Mbps. And that actually comes to 175 shillings per Mbps. So I'm thinking, did Safaricom actually just copy them? Because this new offer they've come up with is actually 175 bob per Mbps, though it's 3,500 bob for 20 Mbps. Fiber starts at 30 Mbps, which is faster than the Safaricom connection. But then I noticed that their packages tend to scale poorly. As you can see here, their next package is actually 50 Mbps for 10,500. 10,500 is actually double 5,250. But 50 is not double 30. So I wonder how Fiber came up with these packages, but you are literally paying double, but you're not getting double the speed. In fact, when you go up to the next package, you're paying triple the first package, but you're now getting 75 Mbps instead of 90, which would be triple the first package. In any case, ideally, I'd expect that they would offer faster speeds for these more expensive packages to try and lure people to take them up. Anyway, that is it for them. I'm actually considering getting fiber when I move out of this place, which I'm hoping is soon, because I think literally there's no other provider that gives you 30 Mbps for 5,250 shillings. So I think that's actually quite a good deal, seeing as even Safaricom has copied it. So I've not personally used fiber, but from my friends who are their customers and from reviews that I've seen online, it looks like their service is also quite reliable, and so I think I can dip in. And there's also the benefit of being fewer customers than Safaricom, so expecting better customer service and so on. The only downside, in as far as fiber is concerned, is the installation fee of 15,000 shillings, though that is actually difficult to find from their website. I tried to look around and I couldn't find it anywhere. I think I only saw them reply to some comment on social media with that, so I'm not even sure whether that's still the case, but I guess, yeah, it's 15,000 shillings connection fee. And that takes us to Liquid Telecom, whose connection fee is also 15,000 shillings. These guys have very high connection fees. I wish they were like Safcom. But yeah, we understand that they are smaller, muscled players compared to Safcom, who can collab with Huawei to get routers probably for very cheap. So anyway, looking at Liquid, their packages here start from 5 Mbps all the way to 100 Mbps for fiber. And they also have WiMAX, which is basically the broadband connection, which we're not talking about here. And they are talking about 75 transmission points. But generally, I guess Liquid has the least coverage for fiber compared to Safaricom and fiber, that is JTL. So their base package here, I can see, is 2,500 shillings for 5 Mbps. That is a whole 500 bob per Mbps. I think I'd rather pay the 1,000 bob extra to get 20 Mbps from Safaricom. This is quite a raw deal. Then we have 3500 bob for 10 Mbps. That's actually 350 shillings per Mbps. They go all the way to 12,000 for 100 Mbps, and that's 120 shillings per Mbps. So you can see they scale nicely, but then to get some reasonable cost of internet, you have to go all the way to the likes of 50, 100 Mbps, which is really out of the reach of most of us, or more than what most of us need. So I believe Safaricom Home Fiber and Fiber by JTL remain the top two contenders for fiber to the home. And my recommendation would be, if you can access and you can afford the least, the smallest, the base package from JTL, and that is 5250 bob for 30 Mbps, go for that. That is probably the best value in the market. Or if you can jump into the current offer by Safaricom, which is 3,500 shillings for 20 Mbps, that's also a good deal, only that I don't know how long that will last. But at 175 shillings per Mbps, I guess those are quite the best packages in the market for normal users like us. Not unless you have the muscle and the need for the, you know, gold tire packages, which come at quite a good cost in the Safaricom direction, but very, very bad deal in the fiber direction. That is it for this one, guys. I hope you've learned something. If you find this valuable and you're not subscribed, welcome to the family. If you have any questions, comments, there's space down below. And as always, smash that like button on your way out. See you in the next one. No pressure.